North Korea. Listen to what UN Ambassador Nikki Haley said after Kim Jong-un's latest nuke test. Roll that tape, please.
Nuclear powers understand their responsibilities. Kim Jong-un shows no such understanding. His abusive use of missiles and his nuclear threats show that he is begging for war.
Peter Brooks is with us. He's the senior fellow with the Heritage Foundation. Peter, if North Korea shoots off another missile, our only possible response seems to me to shoot that thing down. And that's the start of something really big. What say you?
Well, if we feel like a missile launch is a threat to us, whether it's Guam, the continental United States, our troops overseas, we should shoot it down. But there's a lot of things that could be done before that, and there's a lot of things that could be done after that.
Wait a second, Peter. We've said, how many times have we said that we would respond vigorously if they do something else? I mean, we've said this before, several previous missile launches. We can't let another missile launch go now and do nothing about it militarily.
I disagree. I don't think we've set any red lines. I don't think the president has set any red lines. I think we have to react. If they fire a missile harmlessly into the ocean, as much as we dislike it, we have to accept the fact that North Korea is a de facto, not de jure, a de facto nuclear weapon state, and we need to respond accordingly. But if it's coming in the direction of any of our interests, that of our allies, I think we should shoot it down. But that's a first step, and that doesn't necessarily mean war with North Korea, but it could mean war with North Korea.
Now, I want to bring to your attention what President Trump tweeted over the weekend. Here it is. The United States is considering, in addition to other options, stopping all trade with any country doing business with North Korea. Peter, does that clearly includes China? Could we really
Yes.
cut off trade with China just like that completely? That's not likely, is it?
It's not likely, but you can target individuals and banks and other institutions that are facilitating trade with North Korea. Stuart, look at what we did with Iran. You know, what we did is we cracked down on them. We brought them to the negotiating table. We didn't get an agreement I liked. I'm not sure if you liked it, but I didn't like it. But the fact of the matter is there are ways to do it. The problem with North Korea is that Iran traded with a lot of countries, especially in Europe, which could make it much more painful with them. North Korea mainly trades, 80 to 90% of their trade goes into or through China. So China's critical here, but you can go after Chinese banks. You can go after other international banking that facilitates North Korea bringing luxury goods, that allows it to bring things for its nuclear and missile programs to North Korea. So there are ways of squeezing them, but very, very difficult. Sanctions are always tough because there's always leakage.
Sure.
There's front
sure.
companies. There's other agents that are help these people get around that for money.
Let me sum it up like this. You think that there's okay. still room for more diplomatic action. We're not at the point where military action is inevitable. That's basically where you're coming from?
Yes, diplomatic and economic. There are security actions short of war that we can take against North Korea. But I do not believe that North Korea is going to give up their nuclear weapons program. The fact is we have to rely on deterrence. And they're understanding that if they pick a fight with us, it's going to end very badly for them. They need to understand okay. that. But there are a lot of options out there, but getting to roll back this program is almost, I think, impossible.
Well said. Peter Brooks, Heritage, thanks for joining us, sir. Much obliged.